throw out some bullshit in real time about Million Dollar Club, that Shackelford's not going to drop the ball. But the fact that we know, that his eyes, his eyebrows, his face, very prominently visible to Diana in the back, and for him to just be like darting his eyes back and forth in real time, and I just dozens. I wanted him to say like 647 dozens? Dozens?
You needed Sam Elliott for that scene. You needed something a little cooler who made it seem like he was in on it trying to ride with the ladies. I like that scene. And then the ending, I heard, she just shows up and Santa, come on. What do you have for most of that?
Oh, I mean, it has to be the, despite the continuity errors during the game, well, it has to be Age's Offer. Like, it's iconic for a reason, right? It has to be.
What's Age the best? As a movie device, going to Vegas as a desperation move, I'm in every fucking time. I remember that not working. I'm like, all right, I don't want to see how this goes.
Surprises.
going for Demi Moore's character with the dog on a scale of 1 to Shiv with Mondale.
Family.
looks great. Or down with her. What's age the worst? Woody's high school wig in the beginning when they had the flashback is just
unbelievable.
It's like they forgot that they were filming the scene and that they needed to do something with his hair and they just ran down to the local store.
But still second fiddle to be more of a caprice. Sex on piles of money?
Let's talk about it.
It's just the most disgusting thing on the earth.
Okay, I had it just as like cash. Like
yeah.
Physical money, period, because. Suites just, but that's what it was like in Vegas. Like, it was like this fancy suite. It's like fucking awful. Terrible. Look at what else do you have for Wood Station Wars? Try not to step on nitpicks. Well, okay, it is hard. There's overlap for sure. I assume we're going to save everything to do with the real estate and Santa Monica for later.
You know, I had it in Wood Station Wars and nitpicks.
And I had it in both as well. Let's save it for nitpicks. Let's hit it there. Or do you want to do it here?
Yeah, let's do that. What world is this?
In Santa Monica.
In 1993, this wasn't like 1961.
Or like 1803. I mean, it's
huge property.
You only expect to see this much open land in a Yellowstone spinoff. Like, that's it. When the early Duttons are heading out west, that's the only time in any piece of TV or film that you should see this much open land.
That's like a $5 million.
It should have had at least like a dilapidated structure, like
something should have been there, and we should have had a quick line acknowledging it didn't happen and there was an opportunity, but the fact that it's just open land is absolutely befuddling.
It would have been funny to have a current realtor on to ask to discuss, like, how much that land was worth now in the 1900s. To me, it's got to be $5 million.
Just a crossover with Bravo, million-dollar listing Los Angeles.
Get on board. It's an absolute disgrace, and it's a huge hole in the movie.
It's bizarre.
Because
it
they on top, and later they talk about how Jack H's house is worth $40 million.
30.
Yeah. So we have the $30 million house over here, and then let's take a flyer on that Santa Monica beach property, scrap some coins together, try to grab it. What's going on?
So you're more thrown by the price point than by the availability of the land.
The availability makes sense. Yeah, I think it's conceivable. Because you could argue they knocked down, it was a developer, they knocked down the house, they wanted to sell the land. Like, there was a house there.
But was there? That's what I mean. It's like very lush vegetation, lots of trees. It doesn't look like anything.
We definitely would have had a lot more questions.
Yeah.
Maybe they cut that out. I think the thing that bothered both of us was the space is way more amazing and unique than they kind of let on. Like, they were like, oh, this is our dream house. It's like, no. This is, like, the fucking...
This is the Holy Grail.
You found a Holy Grail property. You would totally make sense. You would have sex with somebody for $1 million, try to save this thing. Because it's worth, like, 30.
Oh, God. Not quite as offensive as the real estate, but is this where we talk about the voiceover? Why? Like, the voiceover is terrible in this movie. Even by the standards of voiceovers, it's awful because it's so sporadically deployed. Like, it's very central in the opening stretch. It's kind of origin story, right? These are characters who fuck on the floor in their own kitchen as their underwear is catching fire on the stove top. Yeah.
Oh, your pants are on fire.
An incredibly long period of time passes, and the voiceover comes back in, and it's just so weird. That opening stretch of the film, the initial voiceover, and kind of origin story for Dave and Diana. I don't like the spoils that they spoil. It saps some of the tension. You should have this one question, and in addition to the question of, did she sleep with him?
Fuck yeah, buddy. 9 eliminations by the Potters. Yeah, buddy.